Hey folks, Carl Kuster here. Just wanted to chat to you a little bit about the balance and control on the new 850. One thing that you're going to want to get used to is one finger on the brake. Basically, that is kind of been the new developing style on how to control the sled. What it does, instead of modulating your speed with the throttle where you're in and out, it takes a second for the clutches to go in and out, changes the attitude of the sled. If you hold the throttle very steady, just modulate your speed with the brake, and just one finger is all you need. And every time you want to slow down or set the front end down or settle it out, if it's getting a little bit squirrely in the bumps, just give it some brake. What that does is it pulls the front end down, back shifts the clutch, and settles the sled down without losing any momentum. Whereas if you let off the throttle, instantly the sled comes out of the snow, the momentum goes down, and it also changes the attitude, so when you get back on the sled, it wants to wheelie. The next most important thing about balance and control on the 850 is foot placement. Don't put your feet flat on the running boards, because what happens when you go to lean over, it puts your knee at a bit of an awkward angle, and you can't put weight directly onto the outside foot. What you want to do instead is have the ball of your foot on the edge of the tunnel roll and be on the balls of your feet. That way you can grip the sled with your knee and your weight is straight down through your quad and down through your leg, puts direct pressure on the outside of the edge of the roll, which also gives you the most amount of leverage for your body weight. Put that body weight to work for you. And it gives you balance as well. So you can get way over here and immediately get to this side, and the weight is always where it needs to be. Where it's on the flat, it's not nearly as efficient because you don't have the leverage, and it puts your knee at an awkward angle.